Nigeria is richly endowed with a whole range of natural and human resources, science and technology, and indigenous knowledge. Kaduna has a number of fascinating and historical features. Notable educational institutions in Nigeria are located in Kaduna State, such as the Ahmadu Bello University, Zaria, ABU, Nigerian Defense Academy, NDA, Kaduna Polytechnic, among others. Like many other such institutions, proudly referred to as the legacies of the late Premier of the Northern Region, Sir Ahmadu Bello, the Seradona of Sokoto. Kaduna Polytechnic, as it is fondly called, has indeed lived up to the billing of its founding father, excelling in nurturing diverse citizens of Nigeria in the area of technical education and related disciplines.
Initially, we have all the facilities required to take quite a number of students. We were undertaking before. So with the new intake, we need to adjust on our structures a little to accommodate the extra that we've taken in. I'm sure if you go around the Polytechnic, you will find a lot of activities are going in terms of structures. We're modifying some, we're building new ones, and so many activities are taking place to make sure they have a conducive atmosphere of learning. For the last 14 months, this Polytechnic has not seen any one single strike. Not one single day of learning has been wasted. The students must thank God that they have been admitted. They've been admitted into the most precious Polytechnic in Nigeria.
It is expected of each and every Kaduna to dress decently.
We have about 5 colleges, each college headed by a director who reports to the rector directly. And so there isn't much difficulty. We have a very sound management system. We operate the committee system very effectively. And so we're able to manage our affairs well.
Kaduna Polytechnic is a technology, science and technology driven institution. There's no way you can run an industry without the professionals. Mechanical engineering, chemical engineering, all the sciences.
Kaduna Polytechnic is the pioneer technology-driven institution originally of Northern Nigeria, established in 1956 as Kaduna Technical Institute to provide the Northern region with technical manpower when the British were leaving. This is a polytechnic with more than 200 PhD holders, far more than many second-generation Nigerian universities.
Kaduna Polytechnic has trained over hundreds of thousands of students who are now everywhere in the national economy. Whether you take industry, public service, National Assembly, we have several of our products all over the country, and we are proud that we have made significant contribution to the development of manpower, especially in the northern states and the nation at large.
Kaduna Polytechnic working tall, becoming the best in Africa. Kaduna Polytechnic in the near future, I see it as an institution that people value as the best polytechnic in Africa, offering signature programs that will enable our graduates to be able to compete favorably in the workplace.
Aside the Ahmadu Bello University, ABU, Kaduna Polytechnic happens to be one of the largest institutions in the country. The engineering department of the Polytechnic is fully equipped.
One beautiful thing about College of Engineering Kaduna Polytechnic is that if we look at Kaduna Polytechnic and when it was founded as a polytechnic, I can say it's the pioneer polytechnic in this part of Nigeria. even now, except Chiyabo College of Technology, we are one of the eldest polytechnics. So we are like even the producers of specialists for the nation. And our impact has been felt all over the nation. In fact, we have, on one way, been producing specialists, intermediate and high management specialists for almost all sectors of engineering, as well as for academic sector. We are the only, let me say, polytechnic in this side of Niger that is capable of producing, when you look at, when I mention like mineral and petroleum resources engineering, it's just a general name. But under that particular department, we have 4 specializations. A national diploma in mineral and petroleum resources, which is one specialization. We have higher national diploma in geological engineering. There is no university currently in Nigeria producing geological engineers. And if you are looking for them, you have to go to polytechnics. And Kaduna Polytechnic is one of the pioneer polytechnics producing that. We have mineral engineering under that particular department. Mineral engineering is a specialization that is dealing with refining of raw minerals or petroleum and then sending it downstream for specialists like chemical engineers to now provide PMS, AGO, kerosene, etc. Then we have mining engineering, which is a specialization that is dedicated to looking for the mineral and extracting it in a raw, its raw state. That is in one department called mineral resources engineering. When I go to civil engineering and I look at structure as a specialization, I look at water resources as a specialization, I look at civil engineering itself. You can see, you go to electrical engineering, you look at electronics and telecommunication as a specialization. You look at electric power as a specialization. And very soon we are going to have instrumentation and control.
Mechanical engineering department is one of the oldest departments in this institution. And it has 2 major options, production option and the plant option. Since we said Kaduna Polytechnic, it means we have to be doing some technical services. And these technical services, we can only get it in mechanical engineering, like basic workshop technology, machine tools, technical drawing, AutoCAD, strength of materials, and some many other courses that we use to teach students from different departments. In this our department, in this our great department of mechanical engineering, every year we used to have a lot of number of projects. Recently, there was a collaboration with Kaduna Polytechnic and Kaduna State University, in which we are going to be having a motorcycle in which we operated with solar. And it has been successful, it has been tested, it has been done in this workshop. It has become a national issue now. So we are only waiting for the next instruction so that we can go to the next level.
Basically, farm power and machinery, we have the tractor shed that deals with all aspects of machinery, tractor and implement, planters, sprayers, and so on and so forth. That's one shop workshop. Then we have the processing and storage, because the processing and storage is also an aspect of our farm power and machinery as a section. So we have this one. Then part of the training also involves, we should have the machine shop where basic components of the tractor can be produced. And then in terms of development and manufacturing of machines, we need the machine shop. So that does the most of the turning and so on of the components. Then we have the welding and fabrication. It's another workshop under the farm power and machinery section. That one is involved in training students in the act of welding and fabrication. Then under the soil and water, we have soil and water engineering option of the department. we have the soil and water laboratory that deals with soil analysis and water analysis for irrigation purposes and for domestic use. This workshop where we are now is where the activities do take place. We harvest, we grade, we sort, then we process, and then we store. We have the grading machine there, and then there are some few others. Then, in order that we will encourage our students in the act of development of equipment, we engage them in the development of some of the equipment that we will need for the processing. Just as we said, what the most difficult aspect of agriculture is handling the end product, which if not properly handled, most of them go bad because of lack of either proper storage or processing or storage. So we now encourage the students to go into the development of some of what we will need for the purpose of processing. So most of the equipment here, as I said, have been developed by our students to help solve the problem of wastages as a result of lack of either proper storage facilities or lack of processing facilities.
Kaduna Polytechnic, apart from being well equipped and also updated with modern equipment, the institution is also greatly into research of the problems being faced by several industries. The Polytechnic is enhancing the practical aspect of knowledge and putting less emphasis on theory.
The college consists of 14 academic departments split into two schools. We have the School of Technology and the School of Science and Technical Education. The departments engage in various forms of training using the dedicated workshops. The Department of Applied Chemistry is equipped with a modern glass blowing workshop. The glass blowing workshop has all the modern facilities for modern glass blowing. And we use this for training our students, and we also use it for conducting training for other professionals.
If you want to make a concentration of 16 milligrams,
the department is also equipped with very functional laboratories that we use for training students. In these laboratories, part of the things that the students engage in, production of items, commercializable items. By this I mean things that you can take to the market for sale. The department produces all forms of toiletries. They produce both liquid and powder detergents. They produce bar soaps. They produce all manners of washing agents.
The advancement we have is that usually microscopes come in two forms, the binocular and the monocular microscope. The monocular has only one eyepiece, while the binocular has two eyepiece. So the advancement we have is that we have binocular now that five people are able to observe when it is being focused. Five viewers at a time. Then we also have a binocular which can be projected on the board for the whole students to observe at the same time.
As a deliberate policy for enhancing productivity, Nigerian government is laying more emphasis on homemade equipment produced by the nation's well-talented engineers as against importing low-quality cheap equipment. For this reason, the institution is empowering its engineers and technologists towards these development challenges.
This department, honestly, is training a lot of students for quite a long period of time. And I could remember during that time we used this sword sometimes if New Nigerian newspaper has problem with their own printing of newspaper, they used to bring it here and we use this machine to make the impression for them. Honestly, in the sub-Saharan desert, I think this is the number one printing department that do very well in aspect of training students.
The department is one of the largest departments in the Polytechnic. In fact, it's the largest department. And it has about 11 sections. For instance, in the automobile technology section, our students were able to construct a model car to assemble them to manufacture some parts. They were able to service cars using modern equipment. In the building technology section, you can see from there that they have constructed gates, they have constructed workshops, they have gone into tiles making and other building construction materials. Under Woodwork Technology section, as you can see, they have gone into manufacture of modern wardrobes, as you can see there. The computer technology is just a younger section, or a younger, they have just started, they have just taken off. But then they have done a lot. They have gone into programming. They were able to produce something out of the programming. They have designed our logo. They have designed some softwares for the department to use.
The introduction of Center for Technological Development and Center for Solid Mineral Research and Development by Professor Idris Muhammad Bugaji, the rector, is aimed at bringing together the private and academic sectors to achieve a goal and bring a definite solution to research and development.
We realize Kaduna Polytechnic is sitting next to Panteka, which is a fabrication hub, one of the most, you know, most resourceful fabrication hub in this country. And we felt for over 60 years they have been living together without any interaction. So we said, let us establish a center for technology development so that we can have state-of-the-art fabrication facilities. We can now link up with Panteka, which has about 38,000 apprentices in over 38 different trades. Let us work together. Let us see how we can improve the quality of their outputs. Let us bring our engineering background in design, and let us help them to do the fabrication in a more professional way. That way we can also help them to give qualifications to some of the apprenticeship training they are doing. So that's the very purpose for establishing the Center for Technology Development. And this center is supposed to churn out equipment and process plants for agro-allied industries in the country, thereby creating more employment, because one of the major areas of advantage for the northern states is agriculture. And we felt this fabrication hub will stop importation of equipment from China. Panteka will become our new China in terms of fabrication of equipment in this country.
The led administration of I.M. Bugaji thought it wise to develop a center that would develop technologies. We have completed major four projects here at the center. The first one we did was a granulating machine for a 30-ton fertilizer production factory. Like one of the projects we are still telling you about, the borehole drilling machine, because of the challenges we have in the Polytechnic. Now we were able to get one of our Ford bus that was scrapped. So instead of putting it away, we remodel it to carry a borehole system.
The center, it specializes in carrying out analytical analysis and other analysis in mining sectors. and other fields. The rector is really interested in moving it forward. He set up a committee to find out how the center is going to be promoted. And I was the chairman of that committee. So we sat and we looked at everything and we gave him and we brought out a roadmap of how the center can be moved forward.
The institution is fully equipped medically and good enough to serve both the students and the large number of people of Kaduna State.
Sheikh Mohammed Kangiwa Medical Center is still rapidly growing. And then one other thing about this center is the relationship is very cordial. Yes, so the atmosphere, the working atmosphere is not tensed. People try to do their jobs. And because we have the support of the management have the health of the staff, their students, and I would say the community, because this hospital also serves the host community at heart. They feel it's important, and that is why the management is investing in seeing that the hospital gets what it requires, what it needs in terms of infrastructure, in terms of equipment, and even manpower. So I think that is a very important factor.
Actually, this hospital from the very beginning was for students and staff of Kaduna Polytechnic. But with recent developments, we decided to involve the community around us.
Kaduna Polytechnic, under the administration of Professor Bugaji, has recorded remarkable achievements and therefore left legacies to look up to.
For the last 1 year, I can tell you we have a miraculous intervention, because we were patching up in some dilapidated structures which have been given a very beautiful attention. We are patching up, in fact, like these specializations I mentioned, it was just on a drawing board until this particular, the arrival of the current management, where they now make a bold move. What is the next step? Resource inspection. How do we go by that? We have to go to the agency in charge of that. That is National Board for Technical Education.
If you have a very strong leader like our rector, Professor Idris Bugaji, everything will, you will get everything done. Why? Because he goes around to see that work is done. And that is one of what is gingering us. You just don't sleep on your work.
Da ya shigo wato wannan tasha ta mu kai tsaye yake dauka abu da muke gabatar mu kai tsaye.
Would like our engineers to go through the national diploma program for 2 years, then they can now move over to do their degree, for example, in engineering. And you will produce very practically oriented engineers who can work as both engineers in design, technologies and operating plants and maintenance, as well as technicians wherever it becomes necessary, because they already have a national diploma training. So this is the kind of crop of engineers we would like to produce. I had worked in South Africa and I have seen it fits their economy very well. In fact, people prefer products that have gone through this kind of combined system. So we would like to become a university of technology, but we would like to be allowed to operate our national diploma program, and then the degree program can follow.